No pausing. Hi guys, it's me, Larissa. I don't know if you know me, but if you do,
yes. I think you guys already know her, and if you don't, then I don't know what you guys are doing. You should definitely go and subscribe to her.
So yes, I make DIY videos as well. I love DIYs as much as Ayushi loves them. Yes. And yes, I also make other lifestyle videos.
And I'll also leave her channel's link in the description box and also over there. So you can click that icon and go and subscribe to her. In this video, I'll be showing you guys three room decor ideas. And on Larissa's channel, she's doing
three room decors. And yes, we had a lot of fun creating these videos.
Yes. All the DIYs have turned
out. The DIYs are amazing.
Amazing. You should definitely go and check out. Like, we are so proud of all the DIYs.
Very proud of the DIYs.
We're just taking pictures with all the DIYs.
We couldn't stop.
Also, make sure to subscribe my channel by clicking that red subscribe button. And yes, let's get started. So for this first DIY, which is my favorite one, a canopy, you will need a white net fabric or any other color if you want a colorful canopy. It was really hard to fit the complete fabric in a frame, so here's a picture. It's very long, and when you fold it into half, it's 6.5 feet in height, but you can go for any length as per you want. Now I'll cut it into half. So I have two pieces of fabric. I'll fold the fabric and secure it with fabric pins so that I can put my ring through the folded part. You just have to make it look like curtains. It's very easy. I'll do this to both the pieces. Now you can use fabric glue, hot glue, or sew it, whichever is convenient for you. I'm just showing you guys how you are supposed to stick if you are using a fabric glue. Now I have a machine, so I thought of sewing it. I'll sew both the pieces. So this is how it looks once you're done stitching. You'll have a hollow space to put a rope or ring through it. Now I have just done this on one side while the other side remains the same unstitched. Take an embroidery ring, hula hoop or an iron ring. And then using a white ribbon, I'll start wrapping it around the ring. I'll wrap 2-3 times near the iron clip as it might tear my fabric net. It looks complicated, but it takes hardly 10 to 15 minutes, so it's very easy. And once you reach the end, again I'll wrap 2-3 times around the clip. Now you will see that I have stitched on one side and secured the ribbon so that it doesn't come out. I'll do this to the other side as well. I just did so that the ring looks perfect. You can use a hula hoop and paint it in white color. That will be the easiest way. I'll stick press button on both the sides, put ring through the hole of the net fabric. Put both the pieces and then slightly overlap it to each other. Now to hang this canopy, I'll tie 4 ribbons, so slightly cut the net. Put ribbon through the net and the ring and tie a knot so that it holds the ring properly once you hang your canopy. Do this on all the 4 sides. Tie all the 4 ribbons to a keychain ring and then just hang it. Decorate it with some fairy lights and your beautiful canopy is done. Thumbs up if you like canopy as much as I do. So let's move on to the second DIY, and to make this beautiful dream catcher or wall hanging decor, whatever you can say, you will need some fake flowers, feathers of any color, thread, some beads, embroidery ring and an acrylic paint of any color. I'll start by painting embroidery ring with an acrylic paint. Go for a theme like I went for black, red, yellow. You can go for pastel and make your dream catcher pink, blue with white feathers. It will look really beautiful. So once you're done painting, let it dry. So once it is dried, I'll take some fake flowers in yellow and orange as it looks good with the whole theme. Trim off the stem. I'll arrange all the flowers and stick them one by one with a hot glue gun or strong glue. Now I'll take the feathers. I actually bought this black feather because I couldn't find any other color, but it turned out amazing. So arrange all the feathers and I'll put two golden beads in the top. And then tie the feather with a golden thread. So here's an idea how you can tie. First make a knot and then put the feather through the thread and pull the thread. This way it's easy and you don't have to struggle while tying it as feathers are very light, stick to your hands and very delicate. Make two knots so that it's tight and holds the feather properly. I'll do this to all the six feathers. So I included some black beads with golden beads. And now look carefully. You need to make two knots anywhere in the middle of the thread. Two knots as in one knot and the second knot will be over it. Now I'll put one black bead, golden bead and then black bead. Again you'll have to tie two knots. So tie one knot and the second one should be over it. This way it will hold the beads as you can see and the beads won't slide down. I did the same thing on three more strings, but sometimes I went for three beads. Then for other two, I went for one black bead. Beads look really nice. So as you can see, it's not in the same level. If one is up, then the second one is just near the feather. And the third one is like in the middle. Arrange everything and then start tying each thread to the ring. Now to secure it, just apply transparent nail polish on all the knots. I used double-sided tape to stick ring on the wall and that's it. The next is again an amazing decor idea, a flower hanging garland. So take a stick, well this is a dandelion stick so yes you can even use that. And paint it in gold or brown color. You can use an acrylic paint or an acrylic spray paint. Let it dry. Now take a ribbon and color, you can go for green, brown or white. I think it would be better if you can go for green or brown ribbon. Then I'll tape the ribbon on one side and I'll start sticking flowers in white and pink color, leaves of different sizes and shapes on the ribbon with a hot glue gun. There wasn't like a particular step or way that I was following. I just sticked them the way I thought they were looking nice, not like in a particular manner. I'll make 5 such strings. So make 2 string with 2 flowers each, 2 string with 3 flowers each and 1 string with 5 flowers which will be in the center. Now tie all these strings to the stick. And by the way, I just used golden thread to hang the garland. You can even use ribbon or double-sided tape. And again, I'll apply transparent nail polish on all the knots. So it's secured. And that's it. My pretty flower hanging garland is ready.
So that's it. Yay! We finally did it. I hope you guys had fun. I hope you guys loved all the DIYs.
I had a lot of fun. Yes. I don't know about anyone else, but I had a lot of fun.
So make sure to check out Larissa's video. Even on her video, she's going to show you guys 3 room decor ideas. And they're
really
amazing.
Nice. So please watch
them. They are amazing. One I think is over there. Go and check that out. I just loved that.
Seriously. I love it, yeah.
So go and check out her video, subscribe to her channel, subscribe to my channel and yes,
and
give this video a thumbs up.
Yeah, and before that, leave your comments below and let us know if you like this collaboration, if you want us to collaborate again. And
let us know what you think about this collab. If you have any video suggestions, let us know because we would love to collab again.
Yeah, we would love to collaborate again.
So let us know and give this video a thumbs up. I'll see you guys in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.
And keep inspiring.